Hey everyone, this is Jyotika and welcome to your 7th HTML5 tutorial. In the previous video, we created a simple web page and I briefly mentioned about headings and paragraphs. So today we are going to explore them in detail and also learn about some more tags that are sometimes used with them like BR, PRE, HR and WBR. So let's start by talking about headings. HTML headings are titles or subtitles that you want to display on a web page. It is really important to use headings properly in your code to show the document structure, as search engines like Google use the headings to index the structure and content of your web pages. Also, headings are a great way to let others know what they are about to read, as users often skim a page by looking at its headings. Now, I've opened the same page and its code that we built in the previous video, and we are going to continue working on it today. So this main title of our page, My Favorite Things, is a heading, and there are several of these other subheadings on this page. The H1 to H6 tags are used to define the HTML headings. H1 defines the most important heading of the page, and H6 defines the least important heading. So that's why we have put the heading H1 here at the top of our page to let the users know what this main page is about. And we have subsequently put other headings like H2, H3 and so on to mark the various subtitles and sub-subtitles. A H1 element should be used only once per page to represent the main subject of the whole page. And we should never skip any heading levels while writing code, because it might sometimes cause problems for people using screen readers to navigate through your website. So for example, don't just use H1 and then directly use H4, skipping H2 and H3 altogether on a page. We must always start with the H1, then use H2 and H3 and so on as needed. Another thing about headings is that each of them are displayed like this, with a different and default font size which is set by the browser. And it is really important to not use different headings randomly on your page just because you want a particular font size for your title, as they all have a specific level of importance, as I mentioned earlier. However, you can edit the size of any heading using CSS, about which we shall learn in future tutorials. Also, it is important to use these heading elements as headings only and never use them to just make any of your text big and bold, as again, all this formatting and styling can be done using CSS. Headings are block level elements, and by block level we mean that they always start on a new line. Also, browsers automatically add some white space before and after a heading. If you want to know more about block level elements, then I have made a video on it. Just click on the info card above or find the link to the video in the description below. Now let's take a look at paragraphs. The P tag defines a paragraph. Like headings, paragraphs are also block level elements. Browsers automatically add a single blank line before and after each P element. Paragraphs are pretty self-explanatory and straightforward. You can use them to write any type of text, long or short. Also, you can include several other inline elements like links and images in a paragraph. Now, the visual presentation of paragraphs is not so simple. You can never be sure how paragraphs or any HTML element will be displayed in your browser. Let me show you an example of what I mean. If you take this paragraph for example, the number of lines here depends on the size of your browser window. If you resize the browser window, the number of lines in this paragraph will change. Now, what if I want this sentence on a new line in all window sizes? So let me press the Enter key or Return key to shift this sentence on the next line. Let's see if our sentence has shifted below. And the answer is no. So let me try pressing the Return key few more times. And still the sentence is at its original place. So as you can see, even if I put lots of spaces between words, the word and paragraph spacing doesn't change and the sentence also does not move anywhere. the browser only recognizes one space that we have put after each word and ignores all additional spaces. And this is true for most of other HTML elements too. So what can be done if you want to start something on a new line? There are two solutions for this. One of them being using the br element. The br element defines a line break. And a br element is an empty element, which means that it has no end tag. It is simply written like this. If you want to know more about empty elements, then I have put the link to its video above in the info card and also in the description below. Now let's see what exactly happens when I use this br element. Let me put a br tag here, right before the sentence that I want to move to the next line. So if you look in the browser, now the sentence has moved to the next line. And if I put multiple br tags here, then the sentence moves further below. You can even put it in between words in a sentence to force a line break. So it is very useful when you want to write addresses or poems, for example. But an important thing to note here is that you should use the br tag only to enter line breaks in between some text. You should not use it to add space in between two different paragraphs or in between other elements. The spacing or margin formatting can all be done using CSS. Now there is another element that you can use to put spaces or line breaks in between your text. It is the pre element. The pre element defines pre-formatted text. So if you want your text to display in the browser exactly as you wrote it in your HTML code, then you would use the pre element. It is written like this, with an opening tag and a closing tag, just like any other regular element. Now let me write some placeholder text inside it and include some line breaks by pressing enter and also some extra spaces. And just for comparison, let me also copy this entire thing as it is and put it inside a paragraph element instead. Now let's see how it has displayed in the browser. So as you can see, all the text in the paragraph element has continued on in a single line, ignoring all our line breaks and extra spaces. But if you look at the text here in the pre element, then you will see that it has displayed exactly like you wrote in your code. It preserved both spaces and line breaks. So just like br element, this pre element can be very useful when you want to write poems, for example, where there are a lot of line breaks. Also, the text inside a pre element is displayed in a particular font, usually the Courier font. But you can change that in CSS if you want. Now let me show you something interesting. I will create a p element here and I'm going to write something in it. So yeah, that's a really long word that I've put in there. Now if you look here in the browser, it looks okay. But if I resize the window, the word goes way beyond the screen, and sometimes when a word is too long, the browser might break it at the wrong place. And that looks undesirable and difficult to read too. So in order to control that and to force the browser to break a word at correct places, you can use the WBR element. The WBR element defines word break opportunity. It specifies where in a text it would be okay to add a line break. It is an empty element just like the br element. Let me show you a demo of how that will work. So I'm going to be adding some WBR elements to this long word. And now let's see how it displays in the browser. So in full screen it will look exactly as before. But if I resize the window, you can see that if the word is too long for the screen and the browser detects a WBR element in the word, then the browser will take the opportunity to break the word at places where we put the WBR element. So this element is very useful if you don't want any surprise and weird word breaks. In the previous tutorial, we saw how you can use article and section elements to meaningfully separate our content. But these elements do not show any visual change in the browser. For the visual aspect, we will have to use CSS to apply different styles or colors to show a change in content. But there is a way in HTML that you can meaningfully as well as visually show a change in content, and that is by using the HR element. The HR or the horizontal rule tag is used to define thematic changes in content. So for example, you can use it between different paragraphs to convey a change of content, or even between different articles and sections that have different topics. HR is also an empty element just like the BR and WBR elements. So let's see what this HR element does. Let me put a HR element here in our code in between these two articles of chocolate cake and ramen. And you can see in the browser how it has put this long horizontal line between our two articles. But you should use the HR tag carefully as it has a meaning. It should only be used for conveying a shift of topic. You must not use it randomly because you want some horizontal lines in your content. If you just want some lines for styling your content, then it can be done using CSS. And I think that should be enough for this tutorial. Let's quickly review what we learned. There are 6 levels of headings in HTML, H1 to H6. It's essential to use these levels of headings correctly and in order, as they all have a meaning and a hierarchical level of importance. The P element defines a paragraph and is mostly used to hold a chunk of text. It is also a block level element just like a heading. You can add line breaks into your content using the BR element. A pre element is used to maintain all the spaces and line breaks in a block of text. And your content will display exactly like your source code if it is written inside a pre element. When a word is too long, the browser might break it at wrong places. So you can use the WBR element to add word break opportunities, telling the browser where in a text it would be okay to add a line break. The HR element is displayed as a horizontal rule that is used to define a change in content. So that's it for today. I've put the link to the code for this class in the description below and also the links of other things I mentioned. So don't forget to check it out. And let me know if you have any questions. This is Jyotika signing off. Until next time, keep learning and keep coding.